Good afternoon, everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. This is our second lecture on class 12, chapter 4 from Element Mathematics, exercise 4.2. In first lecture, we already studied different properties of the determinants. Now we have to do question based on determinants. So I request everyone, if you like my video, so do subscribe my channel, and if you give suggestion to me, then comment me on my YouTube channel. So we don't waste our time. Let's come on our first question. Our first question is, without expanding, prove that each of the determinant vanishes. It means we cannot use the method of determinant. I mean to say, we cannot expand directly, as we already studied how to calculate the determinant. But here we cannot be used. So it means we have to use the property. So without expanding, we have to calculate its determinant vanishing. It means it becomes zero. So keep in mind, if you have to prove or to explain such type of question, ask you how such determinant vanishes. It means such determinant has value zero. Keep in mind two properties. First property is if any two row or two columns are same. Ri is equal to Rj or Ci is equal to Cj. So you have to search any two row that are identical or any two columns are identical. If you will find any two row or two column is equal, then you can write according to properties their determinant is equal to 0. If such property are not found, then use second property. Second property say, if you find any one row or any one column has all elements is equal to 0, means if you find any row or column is 0, then the determinant is equal to 0. So if either any row or any column is equal to 0, so determinant will be 0. So if such type of question will put in your final exam, then you have to search two properties, then we can easily find out how this determinant vanishes. So firstly we look our first property. Is it any two row or any two columns are same or identical? Please look 148 111 137. In this there is no row are equal and no one columns are equal. Second step, try to make two row or two column be equal. It may be possible if we apply or to common out or to multiply with any row or any column, it is possible to make two row or two column as identical. So let's try to make any two row or any two columns be identical. Look at each element and focus and find out the relationship so that you can make two row or two column be equal. Please look at this question. In this, if we match this 37, please see 37 multiplied 1, what we will get, which is equal to 37, because if we have to find common, then common must be either in from row or either in from column. So 111 can also be write as in terms of 37. Why? Because 37 multiplied by 3, 3 into 7, 21, carry 2, 3 is a 9 or 2, 11. It means 11 can be written as in terms of a factor of 37. Now look at 148, 37 multiplied by 4, 7 4s are 28, carry 2, 4 3s are 12 or 2, 14. It means 148. So we can factorize these elements. So what we do? 148 can be written as 37 multiplied by 4. 111 can be written as 37 into 3. And 37 can be written as 37 into 1. Now all the remaining elements are same. Now look at 37 is a common factor throughout the column first. It means we can take 37 as a common because 37 is present all the elements of column first. So we can take 37 as a common. What we will obtain? We obtain 4, 3, 1. This is also 4, 3, 1. This one is 23, 17, 101. Now look at C1 and C2. C1 is equal to C2. So according to property of determinant, is vanishes. So we have proved. Please make a note. So this one is your second part of question 1. Follow the same procedure here. To check either two row or two column are same, but there is no any two row or any two columns are equal, then think about how to make two row or two column be equal by taking a common factor. So look at this. Either we can make a factor common so that it any two row or two column becomes equal. Please look at this. Row third, we can make it as how it is. Please look. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. 6x. We have to make 6 and 2 because 6 can be factorized in terms of 2 into 3. It means we can make this in terms of 2. So try to do this. We can write as 3x multiplied by 2. We can write as, because 3x multiplied by 2 we get 6x. Now make 3a. 9x in terms of 3 we can also write as 3x multiplied by 3, because 3x into 3 also 9. Now we have to make 4. Then how we can write 12x as 3x multiplied by 4. We can write as, so in this, taking common, what the elements we have to common? 3x, 3x and 3x. So taking common 3x, from where? This is your R1, R2 and R3. It means we have to take the common 3x from R3. From R3. 3, then what we will obtain? This is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. If 3x will be common, then what we get? 2, 3, 4. Now R1 row and R3 row are again same. So R1 and R3 are equal. So according to property of determinants vanishes. So determinant vanish according to property. Please make a note. So now we take our next part, third part. Look at this. It's very easy because in this we can take 2 as a common, because 2 comes as a common from C1. And look at also ABC and BCA, and we know 2 into 3 is 6, 3 into 2 is also 6 because associative. So ABC is equal to BCA is equal to CAB because all the elements are multiplied, so each are again equal. So we have option. We can take common 2 from C1 as well as common ABC from C3. Taking common 2 from C1 and ABC from C2, and what we will call? 2 is common into ABC is common. We obtained 1 1 1, ABC 1 1 1, and C1 is equal to C3. So again determinant vanish. So again determinant vanish. Now look at this example. How we can make same as make to row or to column as equal? Look at this 1, 1, 1. If we can make any other row is also 1, 1, then two rows are equal, then the determinant will vanish. And it can be made easy. If we look at first row, if we add first row x plus y plus z, it means we have to get x plus y plus z. Now if we add y plus z plus x, it means also we get x plus y plus z. So now apply this. We are applying the operation. Either you can apply it in R1 and you can apply also it R2. Now I am taking apply elementary operation in R1. I want to add R1 and R2. So apply the operation on R1. It means we change in R1. And how we change and what we have to apply the logic? Right here, R1 plus R2. In this we add R1 and R2. What we get? Because this one is your old element and here we get new element. So firstly I write, first element is our x plus y. This is your old and new one is R1. R1 is your x plus y and R2 is your z. It means x plus y is replaced by x plus y plus z and do in same manner. But we will got the determinant matrix. We got x plus y plus z. Here y plus z plus x. Here z plus x plus y. And the remaining elements will be same. Z, x, y, 1, 1, 1. Now we have to take common. Now taking common x plus y plus z. From R, what we will obtain? Please make a look first. Now taking common x plus y plus z, what we obtain? X plus y plus z is common. So here what we obtain? 1, 1, 1. This one is z, x, y, z, x, y, and next is 1, 1, 1. It means R1 row and R3 row are equal. R1 is equal to R3. So determinant vanishes. Please make a note. Now look at your next question is A, B, C, P, Q, R and this. Please look carefully and you get the relationship between all these elements. Here we have two options, to make either two row or two column to equal, or to make any one row or one column to zero. Suppose look at this. Here is A, B, C and P, Q, R. It means C1 and C2 are closely related to C3. But the difference is for X and Y. And we already studied, if you multiply any factor to any row and add to that some other row, the determinant will unchange. Again I said, if I add any row with multiplication factor with corresponding other row, then the determinants will remain unchanged. So we apply the same property here to solve out. If we add this, if we add, suppose our first element is ax plus by, and we have to subtract them so that we get zero result. How we get the zero result? If we subtract this by multiplying a factor of x. If I subtract by multiplying factor is x into a. Now ax will be cancelled out with ax. Now also subtract p. What we have required? Y. So if you multiply y to our second p and subtract them, so ax will be cancelled out with ax and py will be cancelled out with py, so we get 0. Same procedure if we continuously apply, we get one column which has all elements is equal to 0. So you can apply this on a single time or you can apply one by one step. It depends on you. If you want to apply one operation at a time, then it becomes some lengthy. Otherwise, you can do it on only one step. So we can take as two or three steps, so that you can understand how to apply the operation and what's the benefit and how we prove the next question. So firstly, I have to need ax, but there is a. So I am applying the operation on C1. Applying the operation on C1 to make it as ax. So C1 is multiplied by a x into C1. It means we multiply column 1 with x. Then what will be the result? Look at, if we multiply by x, then we get ax, by, b, sorry, b, x, c, x. and on C2 also. What we have to multiply? Y, because in this we have to get Y terms. So multiply Y into C2. What we obtained? P into Y, PY, QY, RY, and C3 has remained same. EX plus PY, BX plus QY, CX plus RY. We apply the operation only in C1 and C2, and we got the this determinants. And how we obtain the zero elements? If we subtract from this the sum of the C1 plus C2. Again I repeat, Y and Y we obtain zero, because if one column becomes zero, then determinant will be zero. Now how we will make any column is zero? It means if we subtract the addition of these two columns from this column, we get zero elements. So we apply here elementary operation. But on we applying elementary operation on C3, what we subtract from C3 the sum of column 1 and 2. It means we subtract the sum of column C1 and C2. But we will obtain, we obtained only column will C3 will be changed, because we apply the elementary operation on C3, not C1 and C2. So C1 and C2 remain same. AX, BX, CX, PY, QY, RY. Now take C3. C3 is what? EX plus में PY minus sum of C1 plus C2. Corresponding element of this, C1 this and C2 has this, and C1 is EX and C2 is PY. Now apply the same here. BX plus QY minus corresponding these two elements, BX plus QY. Similarly this CX plus RY minus CX plus RY. Now what we will look at? These two elements remain same. So AX, BX and CX. AX, BX and CX. PY, QY, RY. PY, QY, RY. And this will cancel out each other. It means we get 0, 0, 0. So, C3 has all 0 elements. C3 has all 0 elements. Hence, determinant varies. Hence, determinant varies. So, such type of elementary operation you have to do practice. Practice makes a man perfect. Whenever you try to do, solve more and more questions, then it, such type of question becomes easy. Otherwise, such type of question becomes very hard and it will be becomes time consuming question. So, try to do more and more questions and apply and to write the logic or the symbol or syntax how we write the elementary operation. Here we multiply C1, it means we have change in C1. So firstly we have to write here on which column or in which row you have to change. Now take an arrow. What type of operation you apply on to change the element? So in this first column we have to change by multiplying a factor x. So I apply the operation x into c1. So such type of operation is called elementary operation. So this one is your elementary operation. It's very important. So make a note first. So this one is your sixth part of your question one. It is similar. Firstly, look at these terms, cos alpha plus delta, and you know this match to your identity. What's the identity? Cos A plus B. Firstly, you have to write cos A plus B is equal to cos A cos B, and if here it is positive, it means we get a sign negative minus sin A into sin B. So apply firstly on this and check what's the determinants we will obtain. Here sin alpha as it is, sin beta as it is, sin gamma as it is. Now cos of alpha, cos of beta, cos of gamma. Now apply this. Cos A plus B, cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. And look this and to compare this, it means we have cos 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 this terms alpha beta gamma, and here also sin alpha beta gamma, sin alpha beta and gamma, we have all the terms, but the terms is cos delta and sin delta. It's similar to as we already did in fifth part. In that case we have x and y, but in this case we have an expression in terms of cos delta and sin delta. Apply the same logic. So we can apply directly in terms of our first terms, or you can apply one by one step. Firstly, you have to take sin alpha, sin beta, sin gamma as sin delta terms. So we multiply column C1 by sin delta. So apply operation C1. What we have to multiply? Sin delta to C1. And what it's required? It's required cos delta. So change or apply elementary operation on C2 is multiply cos delta to C2. So do this and get the result. What's the result? Sin alpha, sin delta, sin beta, sin delta, sin gamma, sin delta. Here cos alpha, cos delta, cos beta, cos delta, cos gamma, cos delta. Now this terms write as remains. Cos alpha, cos delta minus sin alpha and sin delta. Cos beta, cos delta minus sin beta, sin delta. Cos gamma, cos delta, sin gamma into sin delta. Now how we obtained one column is zero? If we subtract, because Please look. If we add this term, is subtract from this term, then cos terms will cancel out with cos term. But here is negative. It means we have to add them. What's the operation we apply on C3? What? C3 is subtract C2, but add, because sign here is negative, here is positive. Negative positive will cancel out. So that's why we have to add C1. Apply this and get the result. Please make a note first. Now apply C1 and C2 will remain same. So write C1 and C2 as it is. C1 is your sin alpha, sin delta, sin beta, sin delta, sin gamma, sin delta. C2 is same, cos alpha, cos delta, cos beta, cos delta, cos gamma, cos delta. Now what we have to add? We have to add C3. What is C3? This one is C3. Cos alpha cos delta minus sin alpha sin delta. Now we have to subtract C2. C2 corresponding is this cos alpha into cos delta. Cos alpha into plus C1. Corresponding C1 is sin alpha and sin delta. Into sin delta. It means this term will be cancelled out this term, and this term will cancel out this term. What we will get? G. So here, same cos beta, cos delta, sin beta, sin delta, cos beta, cos delta, plus sin beta, sin delta. Cos gamma, cos delta, sin gamma, sin delta, cos gamma, cos delta, sin gamma, and sin delta. So all these terms will cancel out. We get sin alpha, sin delta, sin beta, sin delta, sin gamma, sin delta, cos alpha, cos delta, cos beta, cos delta, cos gamma, cos delta. This is so C3 is 0. Then get up in it vanishes. Please make a note. So our next question is, we have to prove such determinant is equal to this term. Firstly, keep in mind, because this question is not a single question, but such type of question has in your books is 8, 10, 12, 15, I don't know. It means mostly all the question are found such type of question. So what's the identification and how to do such type of question? It's very easy, and you have to apply the operation is every time will be same. What you are identifying? You have to identify 1, 1, 1. Either in row or in column, you have to find out any one row or any one column is 1, 1, 1. If it is not, then try to make it first. If it is possible to make 1, 1, 1, then the question is very simple and it will be solved in 3 or 4 steps. If you are not able to make 1, 1, 1, then the question is typical. And on that question, what we have to think, because such questions are based on thinking power. If you think, if you imagine, then this question is becomes very easy. So firstly, you have to, here in this question already given 1, 1, 1. but 111 is given in terms of row. This one is your R1 row, this one is your R2 row, and this one is your R3 row. It means 111 in givens in row 1, row 2 and row 3. So you have to apply the operation on row. What operation you have to apply? It's simple. You have to apply the operation on R2 is R2 minus R1, and R3 is R3 minus R2. If it is present in like 1, 1, 1, 3, 4, A, B, C. In this case, 1, 1 is given in terms of column. C1, C2 and C3. So you have to apply the same logic here. C2 is C2 minus C1, C3 is C3 minus C1, and you get and the result as you want to prove. Please make a note first. So now try and apply the same logic here. Here 111 is given in terms of row, then apply row operation. R2 is R2 minus R1 and R3 is R3 minus R1. Apply directly. What we will got in this, we have noticed we are applying the elementary operation on R2 and R3. It means R1 will remain same. So this one 1, this is A and this is A square. Now apply. We have to subtract R2 minus R1. R2 is 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Now B minus A, we get B minus A. B square minus A square. Similarly, R3 minus R1, it means 1 minus 1, again 0. C minus A, C square minus A square. And what are the notice? Here, it is in the form of A square minus B square. So we can factorize A minus B and A plus B. So make do this. What we get? 1, 0, 0. Here is A, B minus A, C minus A. Now this A square, B minus A and B plus A. B minus A, B plus A. Here it is also A square minus B square, C minus A, C plus A. Now you have to take common, either from row or column. Look at this. In this, nothing will be common, nothing will be common, nothing will be common. But look at the row wise. Here, we can take common B minus A, because we can take common from 0, B minus A, B minus A. Similarly, we take common C minus A from R3. So now taking common. Taking common. Firstly, taking common B minus A from R2 and C minus A from R3. Now do this. But we will obtain 1 0 0 1 0 0. Here it is A. If B minus A will be common, then we get only 1, because B minus A is common out. We get 1 here, A square is this. Now B minus A will be common, then it remains B plus A. Similarly here, C minus A is common, we get 1. C minus A is common, we get C plus A. Now if one column and one row becomes 100 or 100, then expand along that row or that column. Here we got a column, so expand as determinant along C1. Expand along C1. Please make a note first. So please look, we take common, so write also here B minus A and C minus A. Now we are going to expand along C1. So write this. Firstly, we had obtained B minus A, C minus A. Now we have to expand along C1. Firstly, we have to write all the elements. Here the elements are 100. 100. And the sign is here positive, negative, and positive. It means positive, negative, and positive. Please notice, because this element is 0. If we make it a multiply, we get a 0. It means we obtain only a single result, because it makes your question length. Here, if we cut this row and this column, what we will obtain? B plus A, C plus A. Here minus 0. If we expand this column row and this column, we get A square 1 C plus A. And if we cut this row and this column, we get A square 1 B plus A. Now expand this B minus A, C minus A, this. Cross multiply C plus A minus reverse product, we get minus B minus A, and this becomes 0, this becomes 0. What we get? We get B minus A, C minus A. Here A will cancel out with A, and we obtain C minus B. Now what we have to prove? A minus B, B minus C, and C minus A. Is it? Here it B minus A. It means we have to take negative common. If we take negative common, we get A minus B. Then we get B minus C. Here again C minus B, again taking common, negative B minus C, and C minus A. Here it is C minus A. So negative negative becomes positive, and we obtain the result A minus B, B minus C, and C minus A, which is equal to your right hand side. Please make up. Now I am going to take similar question as we already did first. Look at this. Here the terms are also in terms of 1, 1 and 1. 1, 1, 1. But it here, now it is in terms of column C1, C2 and C3. So we have to apply the same operation but in column. So apply. What's the operation? C2 stands for C2 minus C1. C3 stands for C3 minus C1. Apply this, because we are applying the operation on C2 and C3. So C1 and C2 will remain same. 1 alpha beta into gamma. Here, this is your C1, this is C2, and this one is C3. C2 minus C1, it means 1 minus 1, 0, beta minus alpha. This one is gamma alpha minus beta gamma. Now C3 minus C1, 1 minus 1, again 0, gamma minus alpha. Alpha beta minus beta gamma. Now we have to take common, and what's the common is beta minus alpha, and we can also make here beta minus alpha common, or you have to prove beta minus alpha, or you have to make common alpha minus beta. So take common in terms of alpha minus beta, we can write as 1 alpha beta gamma. This one is 0, and we have to take common alpha minus beta, so we can take negative as a common, and it becomes alpha minus beta. In this we have taken common gamma. If we take gamma as a common, we will cure alpha minus beta. Now in this case 0 as it is, gamma minus alpha, we have required gamma minus alpha, so write same as first. Now in this we take common beta, and we get alpha minus gamma, so taking negative common, so if we take negative beta common, we obtain gamma minus alpha. Now we are going to take common. What's the common? Alpha minus beta, taking common alpha minus beta from C2 and gamma minus alpha from C3. We are taking common alpha minus beta from C2 and gamma minus alpha from C3. What's the determinant will remains? We take common alpha minus beta, gamma minus alpha, the determinants 1 alpha beta alpha, here 0, this becomes minus 1, and this becomes gamma, 0 as it is, 1 and negative beta. Now we obtain 100 in row 1, so expand along R1. Now expand along R1. So please expand it and get the result. Please make a note first. Now expand, right? Alpha minus beta, gamma minus alpha, expand along R1. So first we write 1, there is no need to write 0 and 0 because we get the result 0. So 1, this is your positive. If we cut this row and this cut column, we get negative 1, 1, gamma minus beta. The remaining terms are 0. So alpha minus beta, gamma minus alpha, and expand this. Expand it. Minus 1 into minus beta, which one is beta, minus 1 into gamma is gamma. Then we obtain alpha minus beta, your alpha minus beta, beta minus gamma, beta minus gamma, gamma minus alpha, gamma minus alpha. It is so hence become right hand side. So please make a note. Now look at this question, is your type 2. I have did 3, 4 and 5 questions because they three types of question will help you to solve the remaining question. That's why I have already discussed your question 3, 4 and 1st, so that you can have time to do your next question. So this one is your second question. If A, B, C are in AP, then prove that this determinant is equal to 0. So now make the same concept that we already discussed, to make either two columns equal to 0 or two row equal to same, or any one row or column becomes 0. Look at this. To make it as one row or one column is equal to 0, it will be made by you. How we will make? Look at this very carefully. Find out the relationship, and to make it as 0, how we can make it as 0? Firstly, look at, if we add R1 and R2, so I am taking to our first elements. Our first element is 2y plus 4. This one is your R1, and this one is plus R3. R3 is 4y plus 6. What we will get? We get 4 plus 2, 6y. 4 plus 6 is equal to 10. And how we will get 10? Simply by multiply by 2. If we multiply by 2 and to subtract from the sum of R1 plus R3. How it is? We multiply 2 by R2. R2 is 3y plus 5. 3y plus 5. So 2 into 3, 6y, and minus 2 into 5, minus 10. It means 6y will cancel out 6y, and 10 cancel out with 10. We get 0. Again, if we add these two elements, if we add R1 plus R3, subtract twice of R2, we get a result 0. So it happened with all the elements. Look at, apply R1 is R1 plus R3 minus 2 into R2. Apply this on R1. So R1 first element is 2y plus 4 plus corresponding R3 is 4y plus 6 minus 2 multiply R2. 2 into 3, 6y. 2 into 5, 10. Same here. 5y plus 7 plus R3 is 7y plus 9 minus 2 into R2. 2 into 6, 12y. 2 into 8, 16. Again this. 8y plus 8. This one is your 8. Now R3 is 10y plus c minus twice of R2. Twice of R2 is 18y minus 2b. Now R2 and R3 will remain the same. So 3y plus 5, 4y plus 6, 6y plus 8, 7y plus 9, 9y plus b, and 10y plus c. Again, because we have given A, B, C are in AP, and what do you mean by A, B, C are in AP? A common difference will be same. It means B minus A is equal to C minus B. So B minus A is equal to C minus B. So minus B come out here becomes 2B, and which is equal to A plus C. So we can substitute 2B as A plus C. Now write as 2y or 4y, 6y minus 6y, 0. 4 plus 6, 10. 10 minus 10, 0. It means we get 0. 3y plus 5, 4y plus 6, again 5 plus 7, 12, 12 minus 12, 0. 9 plus 7, 16 minus 16, 0. 6y plus 8, 7y plus 9. Now, this one is 8y or 10, 18, 18 minus 18, 0. Plus a plus c minus 2. So, remaining terms 9y plus b, 10y plus c. Again, this will be remain same, 0. 3y plus 5, 4y plus 6, 0, 6y plus 8, 7y plus 9, and this a plus c is equal to 2b. So 2b minus 2b, which is equal to 0. 9y plus b, 10y plus c. It means what we write, R1 is equal to 0. So determinant vanishes. Hence prove which is equal to 0 is equal to right hand side. So please make a note. If you like my video, then do subscribe, then we will meet to take with another video. Thank you for watching my video.